This is Maya. She arrived here at 12:30 this afternoon for the second time. As you can tell, she's pretty stressed. I'm going to let her out in a minute, and I'm going to tell you her story. All right, come on, Maya. You want to come out? Come on. She is a very, very sensitive 8-year-old purebred wedgie Siamese. She was, I'm not sure if she was purchased or adopted as a kitten, and lived very happily with her owner for almost 7.5 years, close to 8 because she's 8 years old now. And she did well living with 4 other cats until the owner got herself one more male, and she did not like this male cat, and she started spraying. And no matter what the owner did, she couldn't get her to stop. So she decided it might be best for everybody in the household to find a new home for this one. So she came into Siamese Rescue in January. She was at the center for a few weeks with Siri. Well, Siri evaluated her and dealt with her. Never had any issues of peeing outside the box or spraying while she was at the center. She got adopted, and 2 weeks later she was returned for biting. Apparently it was unprovoked. I believe the adopter had one other cat, but I'm not 100% sure on that because I can't see those records. But we, at that point, we weren't sure what was going on, but the adopter was quite upset because she said it seemed like she just attacked for no reason at all. So she came to me rather than going to the center because we wanted to see if she would do that kind of biting thing here. And it's not quite as busy here as it is at the center. And the whole time I had her, she would give little love nips, but nothing that I was concerned about. And again, she did no peeing outside the litter box, so I think that issue was resolved. And found a really, really nice adopter for her. The man drove all the way from North Carolina to come and meet her. He spent a couple of hours here with her, and she just seemed to take to him. She settled in his arms and fell asleep. And everything was fine. She went home with him. And a few days ago, out of the clear blue, she turned around and bit him. And he got away from her, and it was a pretty bad bite. We're not too sure what instigated that, but like a day or so later, his cat, he had another cat that looked just like her, and he had that cat on his shoulder where he liked to ride, and Lola came into the room, spotted his cat, and jumped up to attack his cat. So, of course, the adopter put his arm up to protect his cat, and he got bit again. And that was it for him. He was done. And I don't blame him. He had to protect his cat. So, I am thinking, along with Siri from the center, and I've even talked to the vet about it, she definitely does not like other cats. Not anymore. She's stressed, and this is how she reacts. She bites. I don't know if you've noticed, I put a calming collar on her. And tomorrow she is going off to the vet, and we are going to start her on a course of Prozac. I'm going to have the vet compound it, so it's just something that we can do transdermal in her ear, so we don't have to stress her trying to give her pills or anything like that. She's stressed enough. The notes that we had on her, that she paces a lot and vocalizes a lot when she's stressed. So I'm sure that's why we've got the vocalization today. She's stressed. She just had a long trip back from North Carolina, and she's back here now. So what we are going to do, I'm going to keep her on evaluation for 2 weeks and give the Prozac a chance to start working and see how she settles down. And she's also getting ready to throw up again. She threw up once in her carrier, and it looks like she's coming in her playpen, and it looks like she's going to throw up again. She is very stressed right now. All right, honey. All right, sweetie. And after that, we are going to try and find the perfect adopter for her, if there's one out there, and I'm sure there is. I know once any of you see her photo on there, you're going to get all excited and say, oh, I want that cat. But think long and hard. That's why she's going to be on evaluation for it for 2 weeks. I hope you are going to watch this video. Think long and hard and be sure that, number one, you have a quiet household. Number two, you do not have any other cats. And I would suggest even not a dog. No other animals at all. She can be the main cat. You should be a very experienced Mieser owner, have had dealt with a cat like her before, and be willing to have the patience to give her time to settle in. I mean, I realize both times she was returned within 2 weeks, and I really don't blame them because they had other cats, but now going into it, we know what she's all about, and I would really like to see her have a month to 2 months, maybe even three, of a, before somebody decides to return her again if she bites. Because I think as wedgy and as, what's the word I'm looking for? Sensitive as she is, she's going to need that amount of time to settle down. And I know the center is going to be willing to do a trial adoption on her. So that's going to be the kind of criteria we're going to be looking for. Somebody who knows how to handle a very sensitive Siamese cat, willing to give her the time and watch her signals. We think the trigger might be the smell of other cats, or, and I'm not sure about the sight of other cats, because obviously in this room she's going to have other cats in this room, but I am not going to give her a chance to bite me, even though I will love on her and pet me, you know, pet her. So this is Lola. I really think once she settles down and gets over all this, she's going to be well worth the effort. But obviously we don't want anybody getting hurt. And knowing now what she is capable of, somebody's going to have to be very careful. So no elderly people that have thin skin. Even I'm getting there, and my skin is kind of thin, so, you know, I know what that would be like. I would suggest no small children, because it's just kids, they're just exuberant and they make a lot of noise, and I think that would upset her. I think she's going to just need a quiet home where she can be the main squeeze, and you have to be willing to just let her call the shots as far as when she wants to be petted. Don't force yourself on her. And then be very careful, even if she decides she wants to jump in your lap and be petted, be very careful and watch her. And if she looks like she's going to flatten her ear just a little bit, or her whiskers go from being forward to back, those are all signals that all of a sudden she's going to turn and she's going to try and bite. So just be careful. But we will get her started on Prozac and send her home with the Prozac. Of course, we'll follow the veterinarian's recommendations on the dosage. I'm going to take her to a really good vet clinic here that does nothing but cats. So, you know, they know how to deal with these. And this particular vet loves Siamese cats, so she does know what they're capable of. So hopefully we'll be able to find a happy marriage for this cat. So that's Lola. Just be patient. You're not going to be able to even ask about her for 2 weeks. And I'm hoping that this video is going to satisfy your curiosity long enough for you to make an educated decision, even as to the point you want to even ask about her. That's it. See you later. Say bye, Lola. Lola! Oh, as an afterthought, she does come with this Millie bed, and you can't see it right now, but she's got this little stuffed owl that she loves, and she carries it around with her. And she's probably laying on it right now. It's in her bed with her. So that's Miss Lola.